Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to this session in the afternoon. I hope you had a nice morning already. I'm very happy to see people again after 2 years of COVID measures. We're still in small capacity, but I see lots of faces, so that's good news. We're here this afternoon to talk about enabling modal shift. That's not very easy. It has been an objective for the last 20, 30 years. Starting of the year 2000s, the social actors in this country or in this region, the Flemish region, started something called Pact 2020, and their vision was to get a modal shift or a modal split of 40-60 in 2020. So 40% durable, sustainable modes and 60% by car. But now we're 2021 and we haven't reached that goal. Our Flemish government, that is in state since 2019, also has the same goal, 40-60. And even in our big cities, Ghent, Antwerp, and the region around Brussels, it is 50-50. So we want, in those big cities, a modal split of 50% sustainable modes and 50% car. If we look at our modal split today, we haven't reached that yet. We see cities like Ghent, like Leuven, having an even better modal split than that 50-50, having a bit more than 50 sustainable modes, but we're not there yet. Especially if we look at Flanders, 65 to 70% of trips are being done by car. So lots of work to do, not only for the government, but also for the non-profit organizations, for the people in the street to change their transport behavior. I have three speakers today. I'll start with Patrick Dazen. You already see the nice picture of De Grote Versnelling. They want to put cycling use in Flanders in a higher gear. The name says it itself. There are a lot of projects to get this better. Then we have Guy Hendricks. Guy is a citizen expert. He has launched the project together with other citizen experts, I have to say, of course, the project Integrato. And they want to mirror the Swiss and Austrian models for train transport with more trains and a better frequency. So something to get more people on trains. And last but not least, we have Tris. Tris is working for as a mobility coach for the new mobility network, and we are facing big works in Flanders roadworks. We have the ring around Antwerp, but Tris is focusing on the works that are planned around Brussels. The ring around Brussels. When you pass through Belgium, you have been stuck in traffic over there. New mobility network is looking at companies and looking how they can change their mobility behavior. I guess that's all I need to say at the moment. We will have three speakers. There will be a short room for questions and answers for each of the speakers. And when all speakers have done their presentation, there will be some room for a more elaborate Q&A. Maybe very important for the people here, and if you have any questions, just sign and I will come to you with the microphone. If you don't want to ask the question in English, you are also free to ask it in Flemish, and then we can translate it for the viewers home and in different European countries. Hope this is all quite clear, so I give the word to Patrick. Thank you, Patrick.
Thanks, Miguel. So the great acceleration. But first, I'm starting with a few questions. Two questions, and keep your answers in mind. The right answers will follow during the presentation. First question, do you know the current percentage of bicycle use in all trips in Flanders? And the second one, A negative one. Do you know how many cyclists lost their life in Flanders in 2019? What was the main motive to put up the big acceleration, the great acceleration? It was the organization of the World Championships cycling on the road, beginning next Sunday and lasting for 1 week. So the Worlds in Flanders, in the cities of Knokke-Heist, Bruges, Antwerp and Leuven. And in that way, the great acceleration is a copy of the Dutch Tour de Force, which was meant as the bicycle legacy out of the organization of the start of the Tour de France in the city of Utrecht in 2015, Le Grand Départ in the city of Utrecht. So the Flemish authority, the five provinces and the local authorities by their organization VVSE put up a partnership to accelerate and deepen the bicycle policy in Flanders to leave a legacy after the worlds have finished. So the mobility management companies Trajekt and the New Drive, they joined forces and were awarded the contract for putting up the program management by the Flemish Department of Mobility and Public Works. Your servant is the program manager, and Vincent, Sven and Evelyn are the senior experts, and also Evelyn is in the room. Please, Evelyn, raise your hand. Voilà, senior expert. And particularly Astrid and to a lesser extent Louise are the facilitating supports. But what is the great acceleration, the grote versnelling? We want to accelerate and deepen the bicycle policy in Flanders, so to say, bicycle policy 2.0. And how do we do it? We try to make as many fiets deals as possible. And a fiets deal is kind of an agreement between various administrations, companies, associations, schools, knowledge institutions, and so on. And very important is the equality between partners. So the grote versnelling is a partnership between the Flemish government, the Flemish authority, the five provinces, and the local authorities. So it's not a program, a campaign of Flanders, but rather a campaign in Flanders. What is our ambition? Our vision is the ambitions must be higher, so the bar has to be raised. And for that, we put our goals, our ambitions, in a letter of intent, and we included three main goals. So we want more cyclists on the road, and our goal is to have 20% of the bicycle use in all trips in Flanders by 2025. So now it's around 16. And for 2030, we even have a higher ambition, and that will be specified for urban area and for rural area, and also specified for type of trip, commuting, education, and recreation. But we still have to find out which percentage we will put on each of them. Second one, about safety. We have the ambition of Vision Zero, so zero lost lives by 2040. In 2090, it was still 71 deaths in Flanders, so quite a high number still. And we want to achieve that vision zero through an annual decline. Won't be easy. I don't have to explain that, I suppose. Third ambition is to put the recreational and the functional cycling more together. Those cyclists, they use most of the time the same bicycle network. They also have common challenges, but they don't know each other very well. Eh? Why does this type of cyclist behave as he or she does? Why doesn't he or she use, for instance, the bicycle highway? Eh? We know that recreational cyclists even don't know about the existence of bicycle highways, Fietsnelwegen, or in Antwerp, the Fietsostrades. So we want a bigger, greater combination between the two types of cyclists. The The structure of the great acceleration looks not very simple, but in fact it is. We have the political level, the steering group, the Stuurgroep, always is the three levels, the Flemish level, the provincial level, and the level of the local authorities. Then we have the Bureau at the administrative level, and four working groups where the proposals of FietsDeals are being discussed. Four teams: sensitization and awareness, network and infrastructure, road safety, and hubs and services. To put some names on it, in the steering group it's Minister Lydia Peters, Deputy Tom De Haene, and Mayor of Deinze Jan Vermeulen. In the bureau it's Jan Pelkmans, Monica Silvestrini, Erwin De Bruyne, and Wout Baert of Fietsberaad Vlaanderen. And then we have the four working groups. So just, and also the Fietsforum. Tomorrow morning is the next gathering of the Fietsforum. It's a gathering of all the stakeholders who are interested in bicycle policy, in the use of the bicycle. So we want as many of them to bring together to have a big enthusiasm about things that are going on about cycling and cycling policy. Nice picture of our steering group, Minister Peters, Deputy De Haene, the Mayor Vermeulen, and myself. The workgroepen, we want them to work in a flexible way. So not an administrative way of working, but more flexible, so they can choose their own way of working, when, how, etc. They work, they can decide it themselves. And they are presided by two members, one of the program managers, who is doing all the administrative work, and one member of the bureau or a stakeholder. So at this moment, it's Sarah van Elzakker of the province of Antwerp, Wim Pannekoeken of VOCA, Bernard de Dobbeleer of VSV, and Wies Callens of the Fietserbond, who are presiding those working groups. But what about Fietsdeals? What is a Fietsdeal? What is meant to be a Fietsdeal? At least we want two partners. Quite obvious, if you make an agreement, you need at least two partners. Preferably about a supra-local team with results on short or long term. And the purpose is to accelerate or deepen or improve the bicycle policy by innovative projects or best practices. And in the Fietsdeals are put up some clear and concrete ambitions and goals and agreements regarding input from the partners, the roadmap, and the communication. Hope to start a Fietsdeal. You can do a proposal via our website, but it's also possible just to propose an idea. And then it's our job of the project, the program management of the Grote Versnelling, to make a Fietsdeal out of that idea. So we can put people together, we add know-how, we try to help finding money to realize the idea. We communicate about the idea and the outcome and so on. So please use us. We are here for you. And we are here to make your idea concrete. What's the process flow of a Fietsdeal from proposal to political validation? First, it's the Fietsdeal is proposed through the website or by other means or on own initiative of the program management, the Grote Versnelling. Then it's the Fietsdeals are discussed in the working groups, and they can make suggestions regarding extra partners to collaborate with, regarding the contents or possible financial resources to make the Fietsdeal even better. And the results of the discussion are later on consulted with the initiator. When the Bureau approves the Fietsdeal, it goes its way further to the Stuurgroep, the steering group. If not, the Fietsdeal can go back to the working group, but we always hope that It can find his way directly to the steering group, and then we have the political validation of the FITS deal by their members. And from then on, the FITS deal can be communicated, can be worked out, and especially it will be communicated to our websites and our social media. Just to give some examples of FITS deals, we have the first FITS deal was together with the VRT, the Flemish television channel, and Fietserbond, the bicycle users organization, to collect problems and solutions on bicycle routes by the cyclists themselves, and to have this input in the verkeersinfo, the road information, on the radio channel. Second one was Bike for Life, the campaign of Fietserbond and a lot of other partners like Sport Vlaanderen, some provinces, some local authorities. And it's to stimulate during the month of September that employees go to work as much as possible, and therefore their trips get sponsoring by the employers, and the amount of sponsoring will go to Kom op tegen kanker, also the charity partner of the World Championships cycling. Next one, bicycle data. We all know that we lack a lot of information and data about cycling. Who is cycling, how many of them, what speeds, why do they cycle, why do they not cycle, accidents, almost accidents, and so on. We don't know very lot about those questions. So we want to gather as many of that, or as much of that information in hubs, but that FITS deal is still pending. The next one looked very simple, but in fact it's not that simple. We want to have taxi services that they can put not only the cyclist but also the bicycle in or on the taxi. So when the cyclist gets punctured or has another technical problem or even bad weather or stays too long at the pub, that they can go back home together with their bicycle. But that's also still pending. It wasn't or isn't that easy as we supposed to be. Cycle Logistic, the bicycle courier service in Lier. I will come to that later. Also verknoopt naar het werk. And last example here is the toddler biking. The local police officers, in collaboration with communities, schools, and parents, they learn toddlers to start biking. It's one at this moment. It was one local police zone in Hamme and Westminster, of all places, who already did this campaign during years. And now we want this campaign. That it's done by a lot more local police zones. So that's the acceleration that we're trying to do with this FITS deal. What about Verknoopt naar het werk? We try to promote the use of recreational routes for commuting to work by bicycle. The recreational routes are pleasant, they're direct, and most of the time also safer than the functional routes. So why not use these routes? And to create this awareness, we put up road signs starting from recreational routes to a few companies, and not only for the employees of those specific companies, but to create a mental shift in the head of all employees. So to say, hey, I can cycle to work by bike, and hey, I can even use the same routes as I do on my bike on Sunday. And it was the Fietserbond again who created those routes and put up the road signs at the right places in the cities of, again, the World Championships, Antwerp, Leuven, and Bruges. They already are present in Antwerp, and Leuven and Bruges, they will be from next weekend on. The bicycle courier service in Lier. It was the social economy company Werkmaat Visa 2, together with the city of Lier and the OCMW Lier, the public social welfare office, who joined forces to provide a bicycle courier service to help local shops and companies to deliver their goods to clients and to help the OCMW to deliver hot meals to elderly people living around the city. But this is only a local start, and we know and we are also convinced that a lot more smaller cities can provide these services, so we want to put up a learning network to gather knowledge and to exchange experiences. And to prevent that in all those cities, people are, as we say in Dutch, inventing the warm water. Again, I don't know if it's the same expression in English, but so to say. So that's the acceleration and deepening that we are striving to with the great acceleration. At last, some words about communication. We have a website, www.degroteversnelling, of course, .be. You can find all information about our mission, our FIDS deals, and some other news on the website. And we also have our social media canals, Facebook, LinkedIn, Twitter, and Instagram. So please follow these channels so you can learn a lot about the FIDS deals we concluded, we are working out. And you can also, through those channels, make your own proposals, put your own ideas on these channels. And as I said before, we are here to help you and to work it further out so that we, and especially all the cyclists, have a better life in the future. Thank you.
Thank you, Patrick, for this very short, because you're right on time, explanation. First, one little question before I'll go on. Who cycles to work every day here? Let's see. That's already more than 20%, so we're on the right track. Thank you.